Why don't you tell me a little bit about yourself and the Potash Workshop?
Okay, my name is Chris. I'm South African and I live in Cape Town. I started the Potash Shop in 1986. That was a long kind of, it's been a long journey since then. We grew from just being me, and then I got tired of just setting up exhibitions and selling ceramic supplies, which is what I used to do. And I've always loved ceramics, and I wanted to manufacture them. So I set up a studio above the shop where we were in Cork Bay, and it grew from one person that was employed, and then we got our first African painter or ceramicist called Theo in Tuntwana. And then he brought Madodafani and he brought Andile, and so now we moved premises about 5 years ago, and then we moved again, and there are 24 of us. So it's taken a long, slow growth, but it's a good, solid foundation.
Do you have like a certain philosophy or something about the Potash Workshop? Like,
I think I've always wanted to share information. I like collaboration and teamwork and equality. Perfection and design and being part of the world. But I also like our South African identity. I'm very proud to be South African, and it's lovely to have built up on our particular cultural uniqueness. But I think you have to stay in touch with the world.
So, do you have like a wish or ambition or like a goal with the Potash Workshop as it is now, or is it just something evolving by itself? Or do you have like a mindset of what it's supposed to be?
You know, if I really hold on, what I care so desperately about are the people I work with. They have to be employed. I wish they could continue to be employed. And I mean, I did say this to you a bit earlier. It's only if people buy our work that we can keep going as a business. If people don't buy from us, order from us, then we dissolve. We had the recession hit us last year, and that was terrifying because I thought we were going to go out of business. I thought we were going to sink. There were no orders, and then we got a fantastic order. And it did make me realize the long-term implications. Nobody gives us orders, then we go out of business. And so we have to find ways, and that's why this collaboration is so interesting. We have to find ways to keep the guys interested in their designs, interested in, it's got to be a moving, growing thing. Finding new designs, new shapes, you have to keep up with the trends of what's going on in the world. Each one of us brings different things forward, and yeah, there's quite an interesting thing about being male and female. Traditionally, it was the women, in the Khoza tradition, that were the people who made the clay and decorated, who made the pots and decorated. Now I found that the male artists were better. I think what has happened in our business is it's the women who are the supportive ones. We are the workers, and it's the males that are the painters and decorators. I think that within our organization is quite an interesting thing.
Push this together, you understand what I'm saying? Keep the pressure there, yeah. And you turn this. Those G-clips?
Okay.
Because what's happening now, this is pushing this.
Mm-hmm.
Because there's no pressure here.
No.
To keep it in place, so you can turn this in.
Helen, his impondus cover.